Among the giants of prehistory, one stands out, not for being the heaviest, but for being the longest. Spinosaurus aegypticus, a massive predator from the Cretaceous period that stretched over 15 meters from snout to tail, surpassing even the mighty Tyrannosaurus rex and Giganotosaurus in sheer length. With its elongated skull, crocodilian teeth, towering sail, and a unique tail, Spinosaurus was unlike any other theropod. But despite its size and unique appearance, Spinosaurus remains one of the most debated dinosaurs in history. Was it a fast-moving swimmer, a clumsy land predator, or something in between? New research continues to reshape our understanding of this incredible animal. Yet, what if Spinosaurus never truly vanished? What if, deep in the unexplored jungles of Africa, something remarkably similar still lurks in the shadows? This brings to us the legend of Nguma Monene, a cryptid featured in our comic book series Congo 1880, a creature that might just be the Spinosaurus that time forgot. To understand how Spinosaurus compares to the mysterious Nguma Monene, we first need to explore what we actually know about this prehistoric giant. Spinosaurus lived around 95 million years ago in what is now North Africa, an area that, during the Cretaceous, was a humid, swampy floodplain, crisscrossed by massive rivers. This environment was home to some of the largest predatory dinosaurs ever, including Carcharodontosaurus, a massive theropod that rivaled T-Rex in size, and Rugops, a fast-moving abelosaur. But Spinosaurus was built differently. Its adaptations pointed toward a semi-aquatic lifestyle. For years, paleontologists debated on how Spinosaurus lived and hunted. Early reconstructions depicted it as a traditional land-based predator, but fossil discoveries challenged that idea. The dinosaur's elongated skull and conical teeth resembled those of modern crocodiles, hinting at a diet that included fish. Further evidence, including dense bones that provided better buoyancy control and a highly flexible fin-like tail, suggested that Spinosaurus spent much of its time in the water. But was it truly a powerful swimmer like a crocodile? Recent studies argue that while Spinosaurus was clearly adapted for aquatic life, it wasn't built for deep water pursuit hunting. Instead, it likely stalked the shallows, using its long body and tail to navigate murky waters, waiting to ambush unsuspecting prey. Think of it like a giant prehistoric heron, patiently wading through the water before striking. This new understanding of Spinosaurus is key to comparing it to Nguma Monene, a cryptid whose description mirrors this very hunting style. Deep within the heart of the Congo Basin, reports of a strange reptilian creature have persisted for generations. Nguma Monene, described as a massive, sail-backed beast with an elongated snout, closely resembles Spinosaurus in almost every way. The creature's legend, featured in the comic series Congo 1880, imagines a world where prehistoric predators like Spinosaurus never truly disappeared. Instead, they survived in isolation, much like the real-life coelacanth, a species of deep-sea fish, believed to have gone extinct 66 million years ago, until one was found alive in 1938. While mainstream science dismisses the idea of living dinosaurs, the concept remains compelling. The Congo Basin is vast, with dense rainforests and unexplored waterways, making it one of the most mysterious and least documented ecosystems on Earth. Could a creature resembling Spinosaurus have somehow survived the KT extinction, adapting and evolving over millions of years, just like crocodiles and alligators? While there's no evidence to suggest that any non-avian dinosaur lived past the Cretaceous, the eerie similarities between the Spinosaurus and the Nguma Monene surely help keep the speculation alive. Whether or not Spinosaurus could have survived into modern times, one thing is certain: our understanding of this dinosaur continues to evolve. Since its discovery in 1912, Spinosaurus has undergone more drastic scientific revisions than nearly any other theropod. It was initially reconstructed as a standard bipedal predator, then as a semi-aquatic quadruped, and most recently as a wading ambush hunter. Each new fossil discovery has reshaped our vision of this incredible animal, proving just how little we still know about prehistoric life. And that's what makes Spinosaurus so fascinating. It challenges our assumptions and forces us to rethink what we thought we knew about dinosaurs. And whether in science or in legend, the search for answers never truly ends. Who knows? Maybe somewhere deep in the jungles of the Congo, the echoes of the past still roam. 2025 seems to be the year of Spinosaurus, thanks in great part to Jurassic World Rebirth, where there's not only one, but three of them. And while quite more scientifically accurate than the series' well-known and very cool Jurassic Park 3's Spino, they have been received with some controversy surrounding their design. Personally, I quite like it. Even though I'm currently working on a master's dissertation about the representation of Tyrannosaurus Rex, Spinosaurus has always been one of our favorite dinosaurs, and we will certainly keep featuring it as Nguma Monene in our books. Don't forget to like, comment, subscribe, and activate the bell icon, as it really helps us in sharing our project to a wider audience. Until next time.